Okay, so the fundamental question which each one of us should ask before starting on any fancy machine learning stuff is, what actually is machine learning?
This video is brought to you by EpiPies Academy.
Okay, what is actually machine learning or artificial intelligence? So now, to understand this, let's first look at a classical programming approach. Okay, so basically what I mean is that let's look at how we used to solve problems. Okay, so now let's say you have to make a particular transaction from your bank account. Okay, and now if the transaction is of X amount, and now you have initiated the transaction, and now there somewhere should be a computer system which checks your account balance and basically tells if your account balance is greater than the amount which you have to transact, and if it is, you are allowed to do the transaction. If it is not, you are not allowed to do the transaction. So this is a point where we have basically put in hard-coded rules into our particular computer system. Okay, so now if you want to imagine it in a graphical way, imagine it like putting in the input, passing in the rules, and getting in the output. Okay, this is how classical programming works. But now, when we are talking about machine learning or artificial intelligence, we are basically reversing the entire order. Okay, so on the input side, we pass on the inputs, we pass on the outputs as well. So we give in the input and the output, and then after a lot of processing in between, we get the rules as the output. Okay, so this is something which you need to think upon more. So let's say you want to train your model. So from now onwards, I'll refer to a machine learning model or a machine learning program as simply a model, because that is what it is called in the industry. Okay, so now suppose you have to create a model to basically classify the MNIST dataset. By classification, I basically mean to recognize these particular digits. So now the MNIST database is basically a large database of handwritten digits. And now let's say you have to basically make a computer program which can recognize those digits. Then there are two ways to do it. The first one is to hard code the characteristic of each and every number. So let's say you have an 8. So an 8 comes by drawing in two curves. When you have a 1, 1 is by drawing a straight line. Then you have a 9, which is a curve and a straight line. Then you have a 7, which is a horizontal line and a slanting line. So like this, you can go on and on hard coding different rules about different digits. But then you have a problem where if you have a user who writes a particular digit differently, then essentially your algorithm fails at it because that rule is not entered into that particular algorithm. So now, to basically get out of this particular problem, if you use machine learning, you essentially pass in the output, which is the particular number which should be recognized from this particular image of handwritten digit. So you pass in the digit, then you pass in the image as well, then the processing takes place, and then you basically have the rules which are outputted. Okay, and then when you do this a lot of times, then those rules are basically perfected each and every time when you execute this. So first you passed into 8, and then now the model is recognizing that each and every number which is having curves are 8. So then you passed on 2 and it recognized it as 2 as well, as 8. But then you have passed in the value as 2. So then now it got on thinking that, okay, when you have curves, you also need to check for lines. So this is how, by the process of trial and error and by the process of basically getting a wrong answer and then correcting the wrong answer. So essentially it got the wrong answer of 8. Then it corrected the answer to get a value of 2 and then made necessary changes to get that correct answer, and then you have again a refined set of rules. So now by doing this particular cycle, so I call this the loss optimizer training cycle, where you define a loss, where you basically check how far away from an expected answer are you, then you optimize the value of your output, which are the rules, and then you train your model. Okay, so this is the cycle which goes on and on for millions of images. in the real world, and then you finally have a very refined set of rules which you can then use to pass on the input and the rules to a classical programming model, which can then come up with the expected digits. Okay, so this is fundamentally how machine learning works. And then you basically have machine learning doing the same thing for a lot of different objects. So let's say you want to create an AI which can basically start playing games. So then you create two different AIs which start playing with each other, and every time they play with each other, they want to increase their edge over the competition. Okay, so this is how the graph goes on increasing. And then one fine day you have two particular AIs which are very, very strong in their particular game. Okay, so this is just how there are a lot of AI algorithms or machine learning algorithms playing in major esports titles. And yes, that is pretty much it about how machine learning is. While looking at this, you might be thinking that everything is super computationally intensive, and you are partially right, but that is where we go on to our next lecture, where we'll be focusing on JavaScript and how we'll be implementing the entire machine learning thing on JavaScript, which can then be used for devices ranging from small mobile phones to huge computers to even Internet of Things devices like the Raspberry Pi.